Hello children, welcome to your digital classroom. Today we are going to learn about geography class 10th lesson 2 agriculture part 2. In the previous topic we learnt about the types of farming and cropping seasons of India. Now in this video we'll read about the major crops grown in India. After this video you will be able to categorize the crops grown into different types of climatic conditions and soil. The topics we will cover in this video: major cereal crops, pulses, sugarcane and oil seeds. Talking about rice, it is the major crop of India and maximum area is under the cultivation of rice. Actually, rice is the major crop of the world. So even in the world, if we take up, this is the first crop. It is the staple food crop of a majority of the people in India. India is the second largest producer of rice after China. It is a kharif crop. It requires high temperature above 25 degrees Celsius and high humidity. Rainfall 100 centimeters and above. Major rice producing states are West Bengal, Uttar Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Punjab. In areas of less rainfall, it can be cultivated with the help of irrigation, like Punjab and Haryana. Next crop is wheat. Wheat is the second most important cereal crop after rice, and in the world also, we rank second after US. Main food crop in north and northwestern part of the country, it is a rabi crop. It is a crop which requires cool climate, and in India, winter is nicely experienced only in the northern part of India. Southern part of India, throughout the year, the season is kharif because the winter is here very mild. We can take here below Maharashtra as a southern part of India. The annual rainfall, wheat requires 50 to 75 centimeter. The major wheat producing states are Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, even Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan. Then you will also see the small patches of Gujarat and Maharashtra. Leading producer is Uttar Pradesh and per hectare production Punjab. What are millets crops? Jowar, bajra, ragi are known as millets. They are known as coarse grains. It can be cultivated even in the areas where the fertility of the soil is low and the amount of rainfall is less. Even with the low rainfall, 50 to 60 centimeters of rainfall, and when it is properly distributed, it can grow. These grains are very high in nutritional value. Jowar is the third most important food crop with respect to area and production. It is cultivated as a kharif crop, and in southern India, it is cultivated throughout the year. It is a rain-fed crop, mostly grown in the moist areas, which hardly needs irrigation. And we know that when it comes to major part of Maharashtra, they receive low rainfall and that is enough for the cultivation of jowar. Probably that is the reason Maharashtra produces jowar on a large scale. Major jowar producing states are Maharashtra, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. Bajra grows well on sandy soil and shallow black soil. Major bajra producing states are Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Haryana and Gujarat. Next is ragi. It is a crop of dry regions and grows well on red, black, sandy, loamy and shallow black soil. Ragi is very rich in iron, calcium, nutrients and roughage. Major ragi producing states are Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Jharkhand and Sikkim. Maize. It is a crop which is used both as food and fodder. It is a kharif crop. It requires temperature 21 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius and grows well in old alluvial soil. So, where do we find old alluvial soil? Mostly in North Indian plains. So, North Indian plains is one of the best ground for growing maize and it is cultivated actually all over India. Use of modern inputs such as HYV seeds, fertilizers and irrigation have contributed to the increasing production of maize. Major maize producing states are Karnataka, Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. Pulses. When it comes to pulses, it is different types of dal. India is the largest producer and consumer of pulses in the world. It is a major source of protein in a vegetarian diet. They require less moisture and survive even in dry conditions, means they can even grow in low rainfall, that is between 50 to 70 centimeter. It is cultivated as a leguminous crops, which means they can fix nitrogen from the air, except arar. Therefore, these are mostly grown in rotation with other crops. Say, if we cultivate cotton, cotton takes away nitrogen from the soil. So next time, we must cultivate pulses. The reason is that they add nitrogen to the soil. In this way, the soil fertility is maintained. Major pulses, arhar, tur, moong, urad, masoor, peas and gram. Major producing states of pulses are Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra and Uttar Pradesh. So, if we take pulses, we grow soybean, black gram, arar as a kharif crop, green gram, rabi and kharif crop, masoor, Bengal gram as a rabi crop. Sugarcane. For a sugarcane crop to completely grow, it takes almost 1 year. From sugarcane, India mainly utilizes it for making jaggery, khansari and sugar. Nearly half of the sugarcane of the world comes from Brazil and nearly 22 to 25% production is from India. India is the second largest producer after Brazil. It is a tropical as well as subtropical crop. That means we know that the southern half of India is tropical and the northern part is subtropical. So most of the states in India cultivate sugarcane. It grows well in hot and humid climate. It requires temperature 21 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius. Annual rainfall between 75 to 100 centimeter. Actually, it requires good amount of water. And if water is not there, even with the help of irrigation facility, it can be cultivated. That is why in Maharashtra, if we take Deccan Plateau region of Maharashtra, it is not a heavy rainfall area. But again, Maharashtra grows sugarcane on a large scale. The reason is soil, climate and irrigation facility. Now, this crop requires a lot of manual labor from sowing to harvest. The major producing states of sugarcane are Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Bihar, Punjab and Haryana. Oil seeds. India actually started Yellow Revolution to increase the edible oil production. The main oil seeds produced in India are groundnuts, mustard, coconut, sesame, soybean, castor seeds, linseed, cotton seeds and sunflower. Most of these are edible and used as cooking mediums. But some are also used as raw material in the production of soap, cosmetics, ointments and even lubricants. Oil seeds in India cover approximately 12% of the total cropped area of the country. Now, among the oil seeds, the number one crop of India is groundnuts. Out of all the oil seeds, 50% is groundnut. So, where does India lie when it comes to the production of groundnut? India is the second largest producer of groundnut in the world after China. Groundnut is a kharif crop and accounts for about half of the major oil seeds produced in the country. Gujarat is the largest producer of groundnut. Linseed and mustard are rabi crops. Sesame is a kharif crop in north and rabi crop in South India. Castor seed is grown both as rabi and kharif crop. Thank you, children. We'll meet in the next video.